Hello there, my loves. It's Michelle Visage. Welcome to another episode of Whatcha Packin'. Today we have the amazing India Farah. Hi, India.
Hi, Michelle.
Long time no see.
It's been a while.
We've seen each other here and there,
yeah.
But you are gracing our screens again. The last time I saw you on our screen was season 3.
Many, many moons ago.
It was.
Many moons ago. It was crazy.
You get the phone call. And what's going through your mind? Do you have any inkling?
I was hoping for All-Stars ever since season 1.
Right.
I wanted another chance. I felt bitter and mad that I didn't get, you know, to show who I really was. You know, I was young and dumb, but the call came at the right time and it like just clicked and I was so happy.
After your season, you went through a bit of a spiral.
Yeah, it was very downhill. It was a tough time. I was in a bad relationship. Alcohol, drugs, like it was just a whole thing.
All the abuses.
Everything. Yeah. All the abuses and just stacked on top of each other.
So you did a very public post kind of slating Drag Race, mm-hmm. slating drag as a craft,
yeah.
and publicly quitting.
Yes, completely.
And then you kind of quietly came back.
I did. I was currently in Dayton and I quit drag, sold everything in my closet.
Really?
Other than my makeup and moved to Vegas. I wanted to be a makeup artist and a hairstylist for like Cirque shows and all that. So I had no intention on doing drag when I moved to Vegas, but it just kind of came my way and an opportunity. And I was like, well, maybe I should try it. And I gave it a like trial run for a month and then had to rebuild and here I am.
You are a drag queen.
I am a drag queen.
Yeah.
And I wasn't done. And I kind of knew that in the back of my head. I was just so mad at everything in my life and taking it out in the wrong kind of way.
Did you make amends with the people that you may have said stuff about?
For the most part, yes. Like me and Carmen have like hugged
mended.
Each other and mended and I apologized and she like accepted. And she was one of the ones that like I really called out with my like hateness towards this season.
Uh-huh.
And clearly the Mimi thing.
Right. Have you gotten over that yet?
I did, and then some issues happened. And
oh,
it's fine.
Mimi.
It's fine.
It is fine, because at the end of the day, what you can control is your happiness and what happens with you from here on out.
Completely.
And what happened with you is you were on Drag Race All Stars 5.
All Stars 5.
And kicked butt.
I'm so proud of myself. It's crazy to like think. Like, it's a full circle moment for me.
It should be.
I mean, and to have won talent the first episode.
Hello, India Farah. There
Crazy.
Was a talent show.
A talent show.
With incredibly talented, 10 incredibly talented queens.
And everyone did so
Everyone
amazing.
Did well. Even
everyone
the
did.
Ones that were in the bottom
yeah.
still did well.
It was like you had to pick like very nitpicky, like to like choose the bottom queens
People
from talent.
People don't understand that when we say we're nitpicking, we actually are.
Right.
Because the further the show goes, the better you kids get.
And I was so nervous because, I mean, it's what I do on a show. Like I dance and yeah, we put dancers around me, but you can see me in a show in a fringe costume, whipping hair, dancing. So to be able to show that and get like such praise from you and from Rue and have that stamp of approval, like that was incredible.
So you're in All Stars 5 and you hear about the twist.
Oh my God.
What happens when you find out you're gonna be lip syncing against lip sync assassins?
It was kind of exciting.
It is exciting.
It was like, yeah. okay, cause this is like, that's the beast
yeah.
that you gotta beat. It was like anxious and exciting for me.
Cause like a challenge.
Yeah.
Let's talk a minute about, there was a little drama with you and Derek Barry.
Little drama.
What's going on with that?
No.
Vegas stuff?
Vegas drama, yeah.
Okay. That entrance must have been like, great.
Yeah, it was, well, I went to hug her and she kind of just gave me a cold shoulder. Coming in here, I wanted to respect anyone that was here. Like I had a feeling Derek would probably be on, like girls that I may not get along with were gonna be on and, you know, but Rue picked us all for a reason.
Yes.
So you have to show the utmost respect for that decision alone.
Upon your exit, you and Alexis had a little bit of a thing.
Mm-hmm.
And your castmates from season 3.
Yes.
Had this been going on prior?
No, not really. No.
So everything
just
was cool.
Yeah, we hadn't talked probably a couple years.
Yeah.
Like maybe just like a hello online every once in a while. But there was no like prior drama. Like she was really excited for me to make it and all that. And we were going good until I saw her do some things I didn't like.
Which were?
Being fake to Shay, number one. That upset me because I was getting close with Shay and I've always like looked up to her. And,
how do you know it was fake?
Because she came to me, like it was a whole like, hey, we need to get rid of Shay. She's gonna win this, blah, blah, blah. Did you vote for her? That kind of thing.
A campaign.
Campaign.
Okay.
Basically, but she's not calling it a campaign. So when Alexis was sitting on the couch in Untucked, She was telling Shay that she always votes with her heart and honesty and everything, and I was like, I can't deal with this. So I knew I was leaving, and I didn't want to leave with anything on my chest. I didn't want to leave and be mad and be bitter and just have stuff on my chest like I did in season 3.
So you just let it out?
I let it out.
Speaking of which, we should see it all in Untucked.
Right.
Untucked is back.
Yes.
How was that for you?
It was exciting.
Was it?
Untucked for All-Stars? Yeah. I think we needed it, honestly.
I agree.
There was so much all of us had to say, and there's not enough time.
Yeah. Let's talk about your Snatch Game. Hi, how are you?
That was an epic fail. I'm sorry, Jeffrey.
I tell you what, you're a whiz with hair and makeup. I don't know.
I was in my head, like real bad.
Listen, so bad. Sometimes our intentions are pure, yeah. And execution is the problem.
Yeah.
And I think that you had a great idea. Uh-huh. And I think that all the elements were there.
It just wasn't put into production.
Like, correct.
I did not execute it.
Well, you hadn't done Snatch Game before.
Never. Yeah, and watching the others, like, it's probably one of my favorite Snatch Games. Like,
yes,
Shay and Juju alone, and oh my God, it was just so good.
It was brilliant.
Yeah.
Let's talk about your beautiful costuming here.
Yes.
So we saw her.
This is the winner.
She is the talent show.
Mm-hmm.
And you won in this number.
A queen in Texas made this for me. And it's funny because I've known her since I was like 16. She's originally from my hometown of Roanoke, Virginia. And she made that for me for this. And it's basically me, bright, colorful, shiny, dancy. It's perfect.
You know, when you put fringe on the hips, by the way, mm-hmm. it takes normalcy out of a regular leotard,
mm-hmm.
but it also makes any move that you're doing look 20 times bigger.
Completely, yeah.
And this one is probably one of my favorite.
This is my favorite.
That's Good. Love the Skin You're In.
This is like a full circle moment for me. So I'm going to tell you. I started drag when I was 12.
Right.
And
12?
I followed 12. My brother's gay boyfriend put me in drag for the first time. At 12.
You know, I put my brother and his best friend, I want to call it drag, mm-hmm. but when I say drag, they must have been 7 or 8, and I was 3 years older. I put barrettes in their hair,
oh my God.
And I made them walk around the house singing We Are the Chick Chicks. It was a group that I made
up. Oh, my God.
So I understand how you would be put in drag at 12.
Oh,
and did you fall in love? Did you become India at 12?
At 12. India was born, and I started performing when I was like 14 and 15.
Where?
At Pride events, AIDS benefits,
and
colleges.
Y'all can do anything in Virginia. Like,
yeah, we can do anything. When I started drag at 12, I followed a queen, her name is Katia Lee Love, and she's a former Miss Gay America, and she made this for me. Yeah.
It's so gorgeous. It is very ballroom, because like if you did a waltz, you have all that fabric there, and it's you know, when I look at ballroom outfits, I think, this is drag.
Yeah.
Drag queens should look at those.
I always.
Yes.
Always on Pinterest. Always.
Yes, yeah. That costuming is full drag. And this one was your entrance.
This was the entrance, and I actually made this one myself. So
did you do a lot of sewing?
Yeah, I did a bunch of it for this season. I specifically love that though, because I got to enter back into a world that I left 7, 8 years ago, and I got to show the new India per se. So that was fun.
You have grown so much, India Farah, in your drag, in your being. You seem more grounded, and you seem happier, and you've got a beautiful fiance, mm-hmm. and life is good for you.
Oh yeah, life is amazing.
We got to know so much more of you this time. Thank you for sharing.
Yes.
And thank you for bringing all your beautiful fashions here.
Thank you for allowing me to, and like Rue and everyone, and thank you for being so kind and giving me like such great words of wisdom.
Well, I'm really proud of you.
Thank you so much.
You did a great job, so thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Good.
Thank you.
No,
are we having a season?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes. And thank you guys. Yes. We will see you next time on What You Packin'. Bye.
Bye.
Do you want everything RuPaul's Drag Race at your fingertips? Then head over to YouTube now and subscribe to the RuPaul's Drag Race channel. And you will get all the episodes of everything you ever want, including brand new episodes of What You Packin'. Hi.